Hi! Welcome to From Zero to QuPath Hero. Today we're going to be following this tutorial on pixel classification. But if you've been watching the series and you come from the multiplex image analysis, you might have noticed that I ended up very frustrated. Turns out it wasn't my fault, but rather a user interface fault. There is a comment with a link to a video that explains it, but that just goes to show that maybe we may get frustrated while learning with things that are not necessarily your fault, so let's be more generous with ourselves. Anyway, pixel classification, we're going to be doing this today. So I'm going to pop this to my other monitor, open up QuPath. As usual, I will leave a link to the images in the description of the video. And we're going to be working today with this hematoxylin-niacin image. So let's see what the tutorial says that we have to do. So, okay, apparently what we're going to do is very similar to object classification, but with pixels. So this time it's classify, and instead of object classification, pixel classification, and then we're going to train one. Let's start with something a bit more simple. Random trees. Resolution. Yeah, moderate. I don't want this to take forever. Let's do a small region first to try things out. Something like this. So region and knee annotation. Okay. And now what? I'm going to try to classify regions by density of nuclei, because I don't actually know where the tumor is here, because I'm not a pathologist. I'm going to do my own thing. So let's say that this... Why is this not working? Do I have to annotate first? This works. Why doesn't this? It doesn't work within this annotation. Okay, let's delete this annotation. I'm gonna say that this area here is other. This is background, and I'm going to say this is ignore. This doesn't have a lot of nuclei. This is going to be region. And then this has a lot of nuclei. So let's call this tumor. I'm making this up. I'm not saying that this is actually tumor. I have no idea. And then I'll try pixel classification. Can I have this? Only classify that. Oh, I broke it. Oh, I didn't. Oh, it can only do two classes. Oh, I wanted more. It is ignoring the region annotation. Okay, I'm gonna try something different. I'm gonna delete all of this. Let's try something a little bit more simple. Let's just delete this and just do... should be doing tumor versus stroma, but since I don't know where the tumor is, it's a bit difficult. Okay. Select just the reddish areas and say that that is the tumor. Don't quote me on that, I have no idea. And then everything else should be strong. Let's try again then, in this area. Oh, I didn't include the ignore class. Okay, let's include that one. Clearly an important one. Okay, we have detected the reddish, not, that's not red. What is it? Magenta? Yeah. Magenta areas. Which is just that one area. Okay, so with more sensible tasks, it does work well. Okay, so the rest of the tutorial is all about how to improve classification. And three ways to improve that is to choose good regions for the annotation and annotating effectively with small, diverse training samples and roughly the same number of training samples for each class. And then we can also obviously improve by playing with these options. So let's play with that. We have different classifiers, random trees, neural network, logistic regression, and k nearest neighbor. Apparently, this is only a good choice if you're working with point annotations, otherwise it might take a really, really long time. The other ones shouldn't make much of a difference for this task, I think. Okay, logistic regression does take a long time. And doesn't work. Okay, no logistic regression. Run trees. Yeah. Okay. Then we can also control the resolution, which is obviously going to affect the performance. So if we go to very high resolution, does it break my computer? It tries. Oh, but it. Ooh. Doesn't work as well anymore. Classifying a lot of background as strong. So then we'd need to have more annotations. So we would need to include a bit more of ignore examples like this. A few more ignore examples. This is ignore as well. Oof, it's suffering from the change in resolution. Yeah, not responding. It did improve, but it's still making mistakes. So maybe in this case it's better to not have a very high resolution. Oh, and we can also customize the features. Edit. Three channels. Oh, what if I choose all the channels? Scales, what are scales? Different amounts of smoothing. What if I do a lot of it? That helps with the background, but well, what helped? The inclusion of more channels or the smoothing? Let's see. The smoothing. Okay, but then I get this fat borders that are not ideal. So we don't need more channels, we can do maybe just two. And then features. Oh, so many features. So this shows us the available images that it's using for the classification. So if we include, let's include three more. Well, it's going to use them now. We have to wait for that. And now we can see it. Oh, for each channel as well. I don't think this one's very helpful. This one might be. Okay, what else can we do? We can also change this, which apparently you're not advised to use, and the normalization scale, which again, yeah, better not to use. Oh, and there are tips on the usefulness of features. It's very clear that for each task you should use different features, which makes sense, of course. Apparently we should approach this with a less is more view. One more important thing is how to do training from multiple images. We can create training images. I'm going to delete all of this. Yes. And we can do this. We can create a bunch of regions. Classify training images, create region annotations. Okay. And now what do you move it to whatever. Okay. Oh, and it will appear approximately in the center of your viewer. Then I'm going to say it's going to be here for background. And now what? File, save, and then classify training images, create training image from region. What happened? Why? Can I undo this? What have you done to my image? Is it because I had annotations here as well? No, don't save changes. Let's try again. Okay, now it worked. And why didn't it work previously? It's just images of the background. Okay, it's because I have annotations here as well, I think. Okay, let's delete these ones. And try again, once more, to delete this image as well. I don't know why it would do it from all the images. It doesn't make a lot of sense. But I don't have any options to not do that. And now it works. Okay, so apparently you can't have other images within your project with annotations. But if you do it well, you get this very nice train and image option. Which honestly would be equally useful for just exporting like images for publication figures. Well, and that's how you train a pixel classifier and create training images. I hope you enjoyed it, I hope you learned something, and I hope to see you in my next video. Bye!